Does this ever happen to you that once I get this bike, I'll be really happy, or once I get admission in this particular college, I'll feel really happy? But it doesn't happen, and then you feel really sad and devastated. But then after a while, you feel happy again. Does this ever happen to you? If it does, then it's known as impact bias. What's up, you guys? Sarithi, welcome back to our channel. Today we are going to talk about impact bias and how we can avoid it. So let's begin. Impact bias is the tendency to overestimate the intensity or the duration of future emotions and states of feelings. This overestimation can happen for both positive and negative states of feelings. I'm sure this has happened to everyone when they were children. So when we were kids, we would always tell our parents that I want that one toy and that will be like my favorite toy and I'll be so happy and I'll never ask for anything again. You know, because that's how we felt and that's what we believed in that moment, in that point of time. But when we did get that toy, we did feel happy and we were really excited for a while, maybe a couple of weeks or less. And then we don't feel that happiness and that excitement anymore, because you know, sometimes boredom sets in or sometimes a new toy catches our eye. Another example but of negative emotions or negative events is a breakup. Like you go through a breakup and you feel that you will never be happy again, you will never meet anyone that catches your heart, or you can fall in love again, but it doesn't actually happen. It takes a while for you to get over someone and then you fall in love again. So in impact bias, people tend to overestimate two things. One, the initial intensity of what they're feeling, and the second thing is that how long it will go on for. In Gilbert et al. 1998, a study was conducted on people interviewing for a job. In that study, two groups were made. So in one group, the decision of hiring was taken solely by one person, one MBA student. And in the second group, this decision of who to hire and whom not to hire was taken unanimously and independently by a group of MBA students. Certain participants were asked to forecast how they would feel if they were chosen or not, immediately after learning if they had been hired or not. The same way, they were asked to predict how they would feel 10 minutes after hearing this news. Then, following the interview, they were notified that they were not selected for the job. And then they were given a questionnaire to fill out, which reported their emotional states, their level of happiness. And all of the participants reported the same feeling, maybe of devastation or disappointment or something like, I'm never gonna get a job ever, you know, going to that extreme. The way they had forecasted their emotional state would be in the beginning, before the interview was taken. After 10 minutes, they were again given a questionnaire to fill out, which was also reporting their level of happiness. And the study found that what they predicted their emotional state to be 10 minutes after they heard the news did not match with the questionnaire, like what the questionnaire reported, and that's how we came up with impact bias. There are some explanations as to why impact bias occur. One being misconstrual of future events. The events that have not yet experienced by us, but we tend to overestimate the impact that these events will have on us emotionally. We know that future is uncertain, we know that, yet we fail to recognize that our projections are something that we have experienced in our past, and we are just like projecting it onto this future event that may or may not happen. So it's like our future, our subject perception or even interpretation of reality. Second one is focalism. We tend to overestimate how much we will think about this one event in the future, and at the same time, we tend to underestimate the influence the other events that obviously are going to go on in our life, and how these future events are going to impact us or influence our thoughts and feelings. Third one is sense making. Our brain is one brilliant sense maker. We naturally tend to rationalize anything that happens to us. although rationalization is one of the defense mechanisms, but we'll talk about defense mechanisms in another video. So when something bad happens to us, we feel bad in that moment. Immediately we start to feel bad and feel devastated, etc. And then our brain goes into this sense-making mode and starts searching for underlying reasons. And once when we have decided on the cause or causes of the bad event, we start to feel better again. Research suggests that there are four processes by which our psychological immune system deals with any unpredicted or poorly understood event. First process being that we pay a lot of attention to that event. Second is we react emotionally. Third is we try to, we attempt to make sense of what's happening or what will happen. And fourth is that we finally adapt emotionally. But we always tend to forget these unconscious psychological processes that we have that cushion the effects of any kind of negative event. So the next question we have to think about is, how do you avoid this impact bias? Always remember that you are usually quickly going to rationalize any event, and this will reduce the intensity, this emotional impact that you're feeling. This is good news for all the negative events, but not so good news for the positive ones. Also remember to focus on the things that don't change. Let me give you an example. When thinking of winning the lottery, we tend to imagine the event and we tend to imagine all the money that it's going to bring in. But actually winning the lottery does not deliver long-lasting happiness, you know. We tend to forget all the 99% of things that happen in our life and that actually more or less stay the same. Things like you will still feel grumpy if you don't get enough 8 to 9 hours of sleep, or you still have to wait in rush hour traffic, or you still have to work out to be in good shape. You still have to send in your taxes every year. So focus on the things that don't really change much in your life, and that will kind of bring in the balance and kind of keep you grounded. Think about all the future events that are going to happen. Basically, consciously widen your focus. We tend to focus on this one event that is happening or that may happen, that is going to happen. And we tend to avoid and ignore all the events that are going to happen in our life, and we don't actually take into consideration all the impact or the influence these events are going to have on our life. Like for example, a man is feeling very demotivated because he did not get the promotion, and he's feeling like, I don't want this job, I'm gonna quit this job, I'm not gonna have an increased salary, I'm devastated, I don't feel like living, blah 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 blah. And he goes home and then his wife gives him the news that she is pregnant and he's gonna be a father. I mean, imagine. Just imagine that. All I'm saying is try to keep an open mind. Life is like the heartbeat line that we see in the hospital. It'll have its ups and downs. So if you're down today, tomorrow is a favorable moment to be up again. That's it for today's video. I hope this added some kind of value to your life. If it did, then don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up. Comment down below what other videos you want me to do and subscribe to this channel. Join the community, support me. It'll mean so much to me if you hit that subscribe button and hit the bell notification as well, so you'll be notified every time I post a new video. And I'll see you next Friday with another psychology video.